T-minus 20 seconds and counting. 15 seconds. 13. 11. 9. 8. 7. 6. 5. We have both main engines start. 2. 1. Ignition and liftoff of the Space Shuttle Atlantis, building the station and our future in space.
Houston now controlling the flight of Atlantis.
Roger, roll, Atlantis.
Atlantis into the roll, the external tank camera placing the shuttle in a heads-down wings level position for that 8.5 minute ride to orbit. The Florida Space Coast disappearing as Atlantis moves into the correct azimuth for orbit. Thirty-three seconds into the flight, first condensation pouring over the top of the orbiter as the three liquid fuel main engines begin to throttle back in a three-step fashion to 72% of rated performance. Forty-nine seconds into the flight, Atlantis already 2.5 miles downrange from the Kennedy Space Center, throttling up.
You are go and throttle up.
Atlantis, roger.
The throttle-up call from Capcom Ken Ham, acknowledged by Commander Jeff Ashby, joined on the flight deck by Pilot Pam Milroy, Flight Engineer Sandy Magnus, and Mission Specialist Pierce Sellers, Dave Wolf, and Russian cosmonaut Fyodor Yurchikhin seated down on the mid-deck. 1 minute, 20 seconds into the flight. This view from long-range trackers at Playa Linda Beach, north of the Kennedy Space Center, and now the external tank camera view once again. Atlantis 11.5 miles downrange, 17 miles in altitude, traveling 2,800 miles per hour. One minute, 45 seconds into the flight, about 20 seconds prior to solid rocket booster separation. Booster officer reports a good solid rocket booster separation. Guidance now converging. Atlantis' onboard computers commanding the main engine nozzles to gently swivel, aiming the shuttle for a precise target in space for main engine cutoff. Five minutes, 50 seconds into the flight. Atlantis now 344 miles downrange from the Kennedy Space Center, almost 70 miles in altitude.
Atlantis, Houston, single engine, Zaragoza 104, and press to Miko.
Atlantis, copy.
As Atlantis rolls to its heads-up position, that call from Capcom Ken Ham indicating that we can make normal main engine cutoff targets in the event of an engine failure. However, all three main engines continue to function normally. 2 minutes left in powered flight. 8 minutes, 5 seconds into the flight of Atlantis, 780 miles downrange. Standing by for main engine cutoff, which will be followed a few seconds later by the separation of the external fuel tank. Main engine cutoff confirmed by the booster officer here in Mission Control, and normal ascent for Atlantis. And the booster officer reports a nominal separation of the external tank. Atlantis now moving away from its tank.
We saw a nominal MECO, Ohms 1 not required. We saw L4D fail off, no action.